हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, थैंक यू टू ऑल, वेलकम टू सरस्वती शिशु कुंज बगवाला बोर्ड सर। वंस अगेन वी आर हियर फॉर स्टैंडर्ड सेकंड सब्जेक्ट ईवीएस चैप्टर नंबर 3 द वर्ल्ड ऑफ एनिमल्स। ओके, पार्ट 1 वी हैव लर्न इन प्रीवियस वीडियो। ओके, बिफोर आई स्टार्ट टुडेस टॉपिक लेट्स वी रिवाइज व्हाट वी लर्न इन प्रीवियस वीडियो। सो स्टूडेंट्स, एज वी लर्न दैट मेनी इयर्स अगो ह्यूमंस एंड एनिमल्स लिव टुगेदर इन द फॉरेस्ट। आफ्टर सम टाइम्स दे ह्यूमन बीइंग्स मूव आउट ऑफ द फॉरेस्ट एंड दे बिल्ड द होम्स एंड दे ग्रो द प्लांट्स एज वेल दे ऑल्सो टेंड सम एनिमल्स। ओके, बिकॉज दोज एनिमल्स आर हेल्पफुल टू द ह्यूमंस, सो दैट इज वाई दे टेंड सम एनिमल्स। सो चिल्ड्रन, वी कैन से that animals which live around our homes or in farms, they are called domestic animals and they are useful to the humans in many ways, like we get eggs from hen and ducks. Okay, and many people eat meat of hens and ducks also, and many other animals also. Then after we learn that cow, bullock, goat, they gives us milk. Okay, so from that milk we can make different items. So these animals like cow, buffalo, they gives us milk as well. They gives us dung. Okay, cow dung and buffalo dung are used as a fuel as well. It is also used as manure in farm. Okay, manure is what? So cow dung which added to the soil to grow the crops well. So this way, these animals are useful to us. Then after, which other animals are helpful to us? So honeybee gives us honey as well, wax. Okay, then after, some animals help us to pull the carts, like camel, horse, donkey, yaks. They help us to pull the carts. If we want to transport luggage from one place to another place, then these animals help us. Then after, bullock or oxen. So these animals help to plow the field. Plow means what? Make the farm softer. The farmers grow seeds in the farm. So before they grow the seeds, they plow the field. And oxen, camels help the farmer to plow the field. Okay? Silk worm gives us silk. Okay, like if you have seen caterpillar. Caterpillar make silk worm, and from that we get the silk, and from silk many clothes are made, like silk sari, kurtas, etc. Then we learn that dead animals also useful to us. How? So from skin of dead animals they make leather. Okay, leather is made up of skin of dead animals, and from leather the people can make the different things like purse, a belt, hat, shoes, bag, etc. So from leather we can make many things. Then after we learn another domestic animal like cat and dogs. So cats and dogs also help us. Like a cat keeps the mice away from our house. Okay? Because what is the favorite food of cat? Mice. Okay? So they help us to keep the mice away from our house. And dog guard our home. Also, police use the dog as a sniffer. Dog help the police to catch the thief. Okay. Then after we learn about wild animals. That wild animals means what? So animals which live in the forest. Okay, they are called wild animals. Like lion, tiger, cheetah, leopard, elephant. They all live in the forest. So they are called wild animals. Now children, is it possible for all of us to go in the jungle or in the forest and to see the wild animals? No. So that is why we have zoo. So these wild animals are kept in the zoo for the visitors. Okay. So what is the zoo? So zoo is the place where wild animals are kept enclosed. Enclosed means closed from all the sides. So in the zoo, these all animals are kept. So children, we can see the wild animal in the forest as well in the zoo. Then we learn that the different roles of the animals. Okay, like as we need hope to take rest, animals also need hope to take rest. So domestic animals home made by their owner, like many people keep a dog as a pet, so they build the dog house. Okay, and dog house is called kennel. Then after shed, the house of the cow is called shed. Cow, buffalo, goat, they live in the shed. Then after horse, horse live in stable. Then after hen, hen live in coop. So these different animals live in the different houses, and their names is also different. Then natural home of animals like lion, tiger, they live in the forest room, but they live in the den. Okay. Then after rabbit, rabbit live in burrow. Then after rat and moles, moles is also animals like a rat. They live in underground hole, and this underground tunnel, tunnel means underground passage. Okay, under the road or under the building, they make the hole and they live inside that to protect themselves from the other animals. Then from heat, rain and cold, they live in their home. So these animals' home is called burrow. What do the rabbit like, you know, children? Rabbit like to eat carrots. So rabbit, mouse and moles live in the inside the burrow. Then after we learn about monkey. Then monkey lives on the trees. Most of the monkeys lives on the trees. Now which another animal lives on the tree? So sparrow. Most birds live on the tree. And squirrel. Squirrel also live on the tree. Then today we are going to learn new topic. Today we learn about aquatic animals and food of the different animals. Okay children, so let's start our today's topic. What are aquatic animals? So aquatic animals means what? So aquatic animals means animals that live in water bodies for most or all their life. Okay, they live in water bodies for most of their life. Okay, so they are all aquatic animals. Like for example, fish, shark, whale, turtle, octopus, they all are aquatic animals. They pass their most or all their life in the water only. Understand children? So another animals also live near by the water, like hippo, crocodile, crane. They also live in water for some time, and they also live in on the land, like tortoise also. Tortoise can also live in the water as well in on the land. So some animals live near the water and some animals pass their whole life in the water. So animals that live in water bodies for most or all their life, they are called aquatic animals. Okay children, our next topic is food animal eat. So as we learn, different animals live in the different kinds of house. So different animals also need different kinds of food, like domestic animals. Domestic animals live around our house, so they depend on human for food, like cow and buffalo, goat, dog, cat. They live around our house. They depend on us for their food. But animals which live in the forest, like lion, tiger, elephant, they will get their food there also. Understand? Because they move freely in the forest. So this way, different animals eat the different kinds of food. Like dog and cat, they eat the cooked food. And some farm animals. Farm animals means they live in the farm or around our homes, like cow, hen, pigs, buffalo. Okay, so they eat grain and hay. H-A-Y, hay. Hay means what? Dry grass. Okay, so farm animals eat grains and hay. Then after wild animals. Most wild animals eat the other animals. Okay, so here three categories of the animals: herbivorous, carnivorous and omnivorous. Let's see what are herbivorous. So herbivorous means what? So children, if you know, some animals eat only plants. They do not eat other animals. elephant. Okay, they live in the forest, but they do not eat other animals. They eat only plants. So these animals are called herbivores. Not only giraffe and elephant, but many more domestic animals are also herbivores, like cow, goat, sheep, camel, horse, donkey. They eat only plant food. Animals which can eat only plants, they do not eat other animals. They are called herbivores. You can see here the picture of herbivorous animals. Okay, children, I think you will understand. Now, next is carnivores. What is the meaning of carnivores? So, carnivores means what? So, some animals eat only other animals. They do not eat plants. Some animals eat only other animals. They do not eat plants. So, these animals are called carnivores, like lion, tiger, cheetah, crocodile, snake. They eat only other animals. They do not eat plants. So, they all are called carnivores. Then after, omnivores. Now, what is the meaning of omnivores? So, some animals eat plants and animals both. Okay? So, they are called omnivorous animals. Which animals are omnivorous? So, first of all, we, human beings. Okay? All human beings are not, but some human beings eat plants also and they eat animal food also. So, they are called omnivorous. Then after, monkey, peacock, sparrow, bear. Okay? These all are omnivorous. They eat plant food also, as well they eat other animals also, like bear. Bear eat fish also and they eat plants also. Sparrow. Sparrow eat the small insect, as well they eat the grain. Then after, peacock. Peacock also eat snake and also grain. So peacock is also omnivorous. This way, different animals eat the different kinds of food, and depend on their food, we can categorize them into three categories: herbivorous, omnivorous, and carnivorous. Okay, children. So I hope you will understand well about the aquatic animals and food animal eat. In this chapter, we have discussed about domestic animals, uses of animals, wild animals, homes of animals, aquatic animals and food animal eat. Okay, so we learn all about animals. So let's see solve the exercise of this chapter. First exercise, give two examples of each. Okay, you have to write two examples of given word, like carnivore. So you have to give two examples of carnivores. So what are carnivores? We know animals which eat only other animals. They do not eat plants. So they are called carnivores. So let's see that animals like a tiger and lion are carnivores. You can write any other animals also, like crocodile, cheetah, leopard, snake, etc. Second number, aquatic animals. So what are aquatic animals? So animals that live in water bodies for most or all their life. They are called aquatic animals, like fish, turtle, shark, whale, dolphin, etc. So here, fish and turtle are aquatic animals. Animals that live on tree. Which animal live on tree? So many animals live on the tree. You can write any two words there. You can write monkey, squirrel also. So let's see that. Monkey and birds live on the base. Farm animals, which animal live in the farm? So cow, bullock, horse, they live in the farm. So here we write, yep, cow and ox. You can write buffalo, goat, hen also. Cow and ox live in farm. Animals used to pull the carts. Which animal used to pull the carts? So camel, yak, donkey, horse, they help us to pull the cart. So let's rewrite. Camel and horse help to pull the cart. Okay. Now let's see the next exercise. Question number 2. Answer the following question. Okay. First number, name the animals that give us milk. Which animal gives us milk? So we can say cow, that we get from the sheep. Okay, so let's see. Okay, so I hope you will all take care of the